some of those things with you today. But I want you to think, though, to yourself, if you can actually start coming up with what things seem reasonable. So what aspects of health do you think that are improved by regular orgasms, other than just happiness? So think about other aspects of health. Talk to your neighbor. To share, but I would like to hear what you came up with. Does someone have an idea? Do you have an idea?
Stamina.
Oh, stamina. Actually, positive feedback loops in this particular case could mean that endurance, particular to this event, may actually improve due to repeated use. Yes.
Heart health.
Absolutely. Heart health is on my list. Cardiovascular disease. There have been studies done. Relief of stress, right? Would you? You guys don't have stress, though, right? I mean, life is too. No stress whatsoever. Yeah, so I'm sure you don't know about this, but absolutely. So stress, if you could argue, like the one thing that this particular culture at this time in you know the continuum, stress seems to be a problem, right? And this seems like a very cheap, available, especially when we think of the solo version of this. Available at any time you are to yourself. And so alternative to some of the medications we might prescribe for these types of situations, right?
Increases blood flow to your brain, so the oxygen content available to your brain tissue.
Great. So increases blood flow to your brain, and I would argue that any exercise does that. You know, there are programs that, you know, track your exercise, right? I think I was talking to this about Molly, that that there are... we were talking about this, and that there are programs that you can track your exercise and whatnot, and one of the things on there is how many times do you have sex a day, how many orgasms, and how hard was it, as in, like, what was the intensity? Because legitimately, right, depending on the intensity, that it is a form of exercise that still contributes in the same way that other forms of exercise do to our health. So absolutely, that when one of those is an increase in blood flow, well, everywhere, but particularly some of those feelings of well-being have to do with, of course, blood flow to the brain as well. Yeah, do you have an idea? The immune system. So supporting and boosting our immune system. Excellent. Any other ones, Sonia?
Pain management.
Pain, absolutely, right? So what's the name of those hormones and neurotransmitters, the happy hormones in your head? You've heard this, right? Endorphins, right? So endorphins are stimulated by this process, and endorphins indeed can reduce pain. And yeah, that's one of the ones that I have in here as well. Any other ideas that you came up with? I can share some for you. Yes. I was just going to say, I'm surprised no guys have come up with this. Some of them are the same as the ideas that you came up with, but I keep clicking too late on the talk to your neighbor. So here's some of them. Improves sleep, right at the top of the list. Decreases stress. We came up with that. Pain relief. Two ways that can happen. One, of course, just the release of endorphins that happens through that feeling of contentment and well-being and happiness. And also release of oxytocin, which in addition to being a hormone that can help with your brain in a calming, happiness way, it also has shown signs that it increases bonding relationships, something that performs that. You know, someone here in the front said something about it really helps relationships to be healthy and build on themselves, and this is one of the ways, because in the brain there are hormones being released that help with that. Living longer. So truthfully, study done, British study in 2002, and they found a 50% reduction in overall mortality in the group of men who said they had the most orgasms. Dose dependent, meaning the more orgasms they could report, then the better their health status was in terms of mortality in this case.
Do you know anything about multiple orgasms?
Male multiple orgasms. I have read that it is possible for men to have multiple orgasms. Do women have multiple orgasms?
Yes.
They do. So that is something that is fairly well distributed amongst the information. But it is also true that, and the reading that I've done, that men can also have multiple orgasms. The stamina comment was brought up here, but it takes some practice potentially. And the refractory period, and I do love, for those of you in physiology, I do love that they use the term refractory period, right? The refractory period is longer than it is in females. Okay, let's get a couple of others. Lower rates of, so these are all things that have been reported in various studies to have lower rates thanks to an increase in orgasm use. We'll call it use of orgasms, right? So heart disease is one of them, breast cancer, prostate cancer, and endometriosis, which for those of you that don't know, endometriosis, that's a condition in women that involves endometrial lining that's occurring in locations that you wouldn't necessarily want, like outside of the uterus. All right, so all of those seem to be decreased in various studies. Another one, thinking more about age, which I know not everybody in the room is thinking about quite yet, but as we age, women in particular, the most common thing that if you talk to a gynecologist that a woman will come in complaining of is libido starting to drop, and in addition, incontinence. So incontinence, that has to do with the ability for you to urinate when you want to urinate and not when you aren't planning on it, right? And this has to do with the same group of muscles that are going to be doing those lovely involuntary contractions when you're having an orgasm. So they have found that there's a connection between them, although there hasn't been a definitive study that's been able to show how many orgasms do you need to have each week in order to see a reduction in incontinence. So there hasn't been a definitive study, but there is suggestions in that direction. And the other one is painful menses. That's painful menstruation. So like the cramping that can occur during menstruation, that, again, this is something that can be relieved. So the list is looking pretty good so far here. The last one that I found to be quite interesting is that a study that was done to look at folks with cerebral palsy and multiple sclerosis, and they also included some folks with spinal cord injury, and they found that up to 8 hours later, they reported a decrease in leg spasticity, stiffness, and spasm. So a prolonged effect that had to do with the neurological system that was alleviating their symptoms. And again, in a way that was probably a pleasurable way there versus some of the other techniques or drugs or things that can be used to treat. So seems like, I'm bought in. I think it's a good idea. I'm glad you're here to talk about it with me too.